and individuals with disabilities who rely on Medicaid. There is nothing courageous about targeting the most vulnerable in our society. Yet this is the biggest area of cuts in this budget. Block granting Medicaid is simply code for deep, arbitrary cuts in support to our vulnerable seniors, individuals with disabilities, and low-income kids. And giving governors so-called flexibility is a nice-sounding way of giving them a license to use federal taxpayer dollars to pay for their favorite initiatives without oversight and accountability. That's not reform. Medicaid is already underfunded. Block granting it in the name of reform is like throwing a drowning person an anchor. And the claim that dismantling the Medicare guarantee and block granting Medicaid is necessary to save them is, in my view, simply Orwellian. It reminds me of the statement that was made at one point that you have to destroy the village in order to save it. Democrats welcome an open debate about how we can build upon the reforms in the Affordable Care Act to strengthen and sustain Medicare and Medicaid, but we will vigorously oppose any effort to undermine the integrity of these essential supports for seniors and vulnerable individuals. Mr. Chairman, we believe that the Republican budget is the wrong choice for America because it does not reflect what we believe are our values and priorities. It does not reflect the best of the American experience. It recognizes the importance of individual self-reliance that is in a very important part of the American character, but it fails to recognize the truth emblazoned on the Great Seal of the United States, that out of many, we unite as one behind shared values and principles to advance the common good and make America strong and exceptional. And we will be offering next week a Democratic alternative so that people can see the choice before the country. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I put the gentleman down as a no then.